It is time to go back to the diet of Mother Corn and Pop Pumpkin. It is time to go back to the diet of your ancestors. Many Native American cultures, tribes, how you want to call it. Did have one deity, how it's very important, how represented the gift of corn. The most important food source of the Mayas, the Aztecs, and other like them. Many Native Americans before the coming of Columbus and the other conquistadors in year 4082. Columbus described many the natives, he said, as half naked, were wearing little to no clothing, and he also violated some of the first natives he have seen. Not directly, but he have said that his men can do it. Columbus was a filthy, disgusting pervert. And as you ask me, he should be explained in school like that. He was extremely arrogant, and until his death, he was convinced and always say that he was not in the Americans. That's the reason many Native Americans are called Indians. That's because of that bastard. That son of an incubus. That shitty person. But now, furthermore, before the Americans have conquered the Americans, most of the time the only animal how was domesticated was the wolf or dog. Some tribes did have domesticated turkeys, but not for their flesh, but for companions and for the feathers that the turkey dropped, for hair or atrocities for richer tribal members. Many traveling in and Native Americans spread seeds everywhere so they can find their plants when they are coming back to the place where they are first set the seeds, and so they can eat them the crops. For example, some tribes place seeds of pumpkins, mice, and kinds of beans around places, since those four vegetables and legumes or plant foods are helping each other. The pumpkin makes that the roots not dry out so fast, and that they don't grow so much wheat between the corn and the beans. And beans used the stick of the mice to grow up into the high part of them. So the root of the beans give some vitamins and spores that are good for the growth of the pumpkin and the mice corn. According to Rita lore, the how is a part of the Native American culture of the Choctaw Indian or Native Americans of Oklahoma. Her people have nothing wear feathers in their hair. Their traditional clothing is made from cotton, with articulal patterns on the clothing for the woman and more based clothing for the man, also made from cotton. Their homes were traditional, made from clay and bark and cane and such stuff. The Choctaws and many other Native Americans were first and foremost plant farmers. With the introduction of the tools and customs of the white man, many more Native Americans starting to eat more like kings and queens, and getting also diseases with the plague, and the measles and such diseases killing off in the first edge of time over 80%, according to some statistics, of the total population of the native population. Yes, the white man was a disease. He bring diseases. He bring take away the native people from the land. He steals their land without permission, and the natives must surrender. Just they are acting in a terrible way. They tough down the white man in the town, destroy their cultures, their history. The conquistadors enslave them, place them in reservoirs, and make them addictive to drugs and alcohol, to mutton their conscience, since there was a very high demand of buffalo tongue by the white man. The intoxicated of the Indians times how were friendly to the white man, hunted most buffaloes to near extinction because of the demand, supply and demand practice of the capitalist system, how it does not care about ecology, and because of their own belief that the great spirit always brings the buffalo back out of the dead, or something like that. Silly stories people like to tell each other. The traditional food of the Native American existed out of one stew made from corn, pumpkin and beans. Word also comes back from that I said that many traveling tribes actually plant everywhere where their ground was fertile enough, seeds from pumpkins and corn and mice. I used that combination of vegetables, by the way, also in my garden, since, yes, I grow some of my own food. And it's pretty funny also, pretty nice. I make that then in pots, so I've also in the winter put them in bottles like this, and I'm closing it, and then I can eat it in the winter when the plants don't grow in my country. But furthermore, their bread was made from corn and acorn nuts, or roast corn was one of their favorites, along with corn perch, like Rita Lohr, PhD, in her articles say about the traditional diets of her people, the Oklahoma Native Americans. The picture most people have from the Native American is actually of some kinds of the Apache in Native Americans, who are not a great representation of the majority of the Native cultures before the settlements of the Americans. If you look to the greatest buildings built by the Mayas and the Aztecs, you see that their culture was far more advanced than those tribal people, even if they are not from high class in the society of the group. The Native American population did have, according to Rita Laws, the land of Oklahoma was chosen to place the her people in is because of the explorers from the white men deemed their land to be infertile and uninhabitable, and therefore they give faith to the Choctaw. In reality, Oklahoma was Indian fruit basket. It was so fertile that the Indians that survived the Trail of Tears built there in Oklahoma a new and plentiful culture and home, which is their agricultural genius still intact. Maybe you'll have to think a little bit more civilized. So I say before, there is not something as a meat, dairy and egg eating environmentalist. Always not one how I can take serious, since the animal agriculture industry is the most biggest cost of environmental damage. And many natives claim that they care about the environment, even if they are not vegan, but there should be, since 81% of all the deforestation is directly caused by animal agriculture. Of that is 70% to 75%. Or actually cattle ranching. So it is easy to say what is more sustainable, a plant-based diet or an animal flesh-based diet. The average American diet costs around 3 acres of land per person, but a vegan diet costs only 1/6 of an acre of land. So it is far more sustainable, it costs less land, less deforestation, less greenhouse gas emissions also. Oh yeah, 51% of all the greenhouse gas emissions come from animal agriculture, World Watch Institute 8. So, when darkness and light become one, the reality splintered away and the truth become visible. Peace begins on the dinner table by what you eat on a daily basis.